Okay, welcome to video 4 of this series. Last time we created the configuration data type for getting config data in, which will probably also grow if we need this. So for now, I just want to do some refactoring. So this connect client class, I want to pull this out here. And probably we need the settings. Okay. For IOB. Couldn't match the value of vector type client settings. So we need to, of course, if we call this, we need to pass the settings again. And same is here. If we call this connect client, we need to pass the settings. Yes, and this has to be also part of the type signature, and of course also here, and we're good. Okay, so now the main function is a little bit more slick. Next thing is, actually we have created the config, but now we want to get it from the file or the default if nothing is specified. So we need some command line parsing the options. We want to give the application now some command line switches. And we do this, we have the executable here. I want to use the opt-parse generic library. So let's see. Yes, that's good. And so basically what this does is we create an data type, some type parameter, and sorry, I have to cheat a little bit because I always forget this. I just want to go quickly over this if you want to. So then the name of the type, and then we create some fields. One is we want some version information. It's not important for now, but this is some stuff from the opt-generics library. I don't want to go too much into detail with this. And display version information. So, and we have a second field config, which is a maybe string. And specify a config file. Okay, so now we don't have this in scope, so we need options generic. Illegal type operator, so we need use type operators. Okay. And data kinds, and we're good. Okay, so what this does actually is this uses some type level trickery, which I don't want to go at. Just know how to use it. I don't know how it exactly works though. So this will be converted into the command line switches. This is then a phantom value so that we have a little bit easier access. And this one is a bool. So if this minus minus version is asked, then this bool will be set. And this is a string, has an optional string with it. And so minus, you specified in minus minus config and then a file name, something like that. And of course, we need to then, of course, parse this. And this is what the first thing we do in main. The options and the let's see, opt parse generic. So you have here a detailed description of how this works. Yeah, so you can work through it. So the thing is, we have this unwrap. I think it's called unwrap record. Yes. Yes. Let's do it. Just unwrap record and a text. The text is the name of the program, so tutorial telemetry. And yes, of course, we then have it doesn't know to which type it needs to. So let's help the type inference a little bit. So in case of the version flag, we just want to put out the version. So when we use we could use if, but in the else case, we don't have that, so just use it when version opts. So this now infers that it should be an options type. So we just does version tutorial something like that, and then probably we just should exit. Yes. Okay. Bloop, and then okay. Unwrap record. Ah, did I forget something? Yeah, of course, of course. We need to derive generic, and still something doesn't work. Ah, yeah. Ah. Instance. Yes, of course. The message says we need a pass record instance options. Wrapped and deriving instance show options wrapped. And the deriving instance, yes, we need standalone deriving. Illegal instance declaration. Flexible instances. No. Okay, if you say so. Flexible instances. And we're good. So, okay, so the next is we want to check if the option is passed for the config file, so if this option is passed. So let's check. And then we want to generate a config, which we can use here. So config opts. So call this on this data structure of if we have nothing, then we want to have the default config. And if we have just the file, what we actually want to do is load the file. Yeah. So load, it's called read config file, right? Of left error. And for now, what's through line? And we don't want to continue, so we do exit failure. And if we have a config, kill config. Okay, so we return this now config. And this compiles, and then we can remove. Oh, it doesn't. Okay. So the thing is, we haven't enabled some of the warnings we should have. So I will quickly check which ones I normally enable. So we should also in the library. We all incomplete record updates are incomplete only patterns. Redundant constraints, and also want this F unbox strict fields and F reverse errors. Okay. And then we need to restart Cobol, GCID. Okay, and now we get, for example, that this import is redundant, so we remove it. Then we have this E is not used, so yes, okay, and we're good. So let's try this. So let's terminate this stack run, and if you now put the version, then we should. Of course, if you want to put this to stack run, you have to do it this way. And we get version information. And what we actually should also do is maybe add another option, write config. Write default config to a file. Right? So in this case, and if we have when write conf, no, not write gen, write config ops. Write config default config to default config JSON. Yeah, it's called the same. Let's do this. Write default config. Okay, and now we have this default config JSON file here. Let's have a look. And yeah, this is the packed information, so I want to have this a little bit more readable. So the one thing is, let's duplicate ASON pretty. Yes. A drop-in replacement, just ASON encode pretty. Very good. And the data ASON encode pretty. Okay. So we go into the config. Import. And encode. Where is this? Pretty. And okay. From this, of course, and the thing is, ASON encode pretty has also a config, so it is the same data structure, but we just need the encode pretty function, and then we're good. Okay, so let's call this again. And we probably should also, just to forget this always, load default config into default config.json. Just that we have some feedback. Load default config, yes, okay. And if you have now a look at it, it's now pretty formatted. Easier to read for us humans. So, yes, I would say this is it for now, for this video. And in the next one, we will go into the real work and then start to work on the binary data and how to parse it. We have now a skeleton which we can work with. One of the things still to do later maybe is add logging. Rio provides already a logging function. And we will see if we pass this configuration on, maybe we should use the Rio monad itself, or which is a reader T monad in disguise. We will have a look at that later. So next thing will be then to decode actually the first level. So these are multiple protocol levels, and we will subsequently decode them one by one. Okay, that's it.